Welcome back to Island of Misfit Toy Collectors. Dreadnought Ryan here, and what a stream that Joe team had today. We got to see some awesome pre-order reveals, also some pretty cool name-only reveals, and the digital renders for some of the figures we get to look forward to for the rest of 2023. So let's go ahead and get started. Overall, for the name-only reveals, I think this is just a home run. The fact that we're getting Mutt and Junkyard in the Joe line, it's been a figure that we've all been asking for a long time now. So hopefully getting to see this amazing combo. I can't wait to see what they do with the articulation for Junkyard. And then, of course, Mutt, you know, seeing what they can do with that Giganto stash that he has, and then how the sculpt comes out for this particular figure. You know, we'll get to see him in the Mad Marauders line as well too. So repaints will be available for some of these figures. Big Boa, Cobra's trainer, will be joining the ranks as well. So I can't wait to see what they do with this big chunky guy. And then what accessories he comes with. Will he get the classic boxing gloves, or will we get more MMA style gloves? I think it's just exciting to see what will come with that particular figure. And of course, Quick Kick. Now all we need is Alpine, and we can all relive those memories from the Real American Hero Sunbow cartoon. But again, it's another thing of what will we get to see with this particular figure. I think we are starting to see this line continue to grow. And for all of those folks out there who are saying that the end is near, yeah, the end is not near. I think we're going to continue to see figures being brought out for the next couple years. And as long as they keep selling, I don't see why Hasbro won't stop making this particular line. So let's talk about some of the digital renders. The Tunnel Rat, I think, is an absolute home run. It's a nice homage to the Real American Hero. Tunnel Rat, which was, you know, of course, Larry Hama, who it was designed after. We do get the flashlights that will peg into the backpack. And of course, the weapons that come with Tunnel Rat are a nice throwback to what he came with the O-ring style figure. And then the inclusion of the night vision goggles, I think, is a nice added accessory for this particular figure. This will be a must-buy for me easily. Firefly, we're getting a more classic-looking Firefly instead of the bomb disposal tech Firefly. So we're getting that old-school feeling that we all remember, a nice throwback for his machine gun and his pistol, as well as a nice homage to the old-school backpack that he had with the little, you know, bomb-making kit in the back. He will get the night vision type goggles, as well as it looks like he's going to get a little remote control vehicle with some bombs that we'll be able to strap on. I think this is just a nice upgraded version to the Firefly that we've already seen. And then figuring out some way of tying in the drone and the remote control onto my figure will be a challenge that I look forward to. Lowlight's probably the biggest home run for me. This is a nice homage, and I'm going to continue to use that word, but it's a nice throwback to the 30th and 50th Lowlight that we saw right down to the gun case and the backpack. I do like the fact that the sculpting for Lowlight's jacket is not an overlay, but actually sculpting for the figure. That will help to get this figure in these nice sniper poses that we all want to get him into for figure photography. Lenny also called out that the glasses or the goggles are removable, so you will be able to put those in to different positions as well. I think this is just going to be a nice home run figure. And of course, with Gridiron putting out their 50 cal set, just another opportunity for, if you want to, you can definitely pimp your figures and upgrade them into a style that you want them in. Shadow Tracker, which came from the Pursuit of Cobra line, which was a new figure. One of those hard to find figures, but man, the folks who had him absolutely loved him. He is a jungle warfare trooper for Cobra. The skull mask with the darkened out eyes with the white pupils, it's just haunting. And then to put that translucent skull mask over the top of it, it's just a home run by Lenny and the team. I do also like the paint apps that they added for his dreadlocks, and then all of the little additions, like with the jaguar mask for his arm, and then also some of the bone additions, which look like trophies that this particular character has collected over the time in the jungle. I think this will be a great foe for any of your Jungle Joes, you know, for them to be able to go out and fight, as well as just for some of the Dio picks that you'll be able to take with this particular figure. This brings us into the, from digital renders to actually production samples. So we did get to see Copperhead, which again, they did a great job with this particular figure. I like the sculpting for the chest. You can see muscle definition in there. The helmet looks correct. And I do like the assortment of weapons that Copperhead does come with. Again, the only thing I could really just complain about is, man, it would be nice to see a water moccasin for this particular figure. But again, I think this is a home run with this particular figure. And I do kind of like the updates for the box art. But I would like to see more focus on what the artists were giving us for some of these Joes. But for this particular figure, I think he another home run from the Joe team. Bazooka, we've seen Bazooka, of course, through Tiger Force, but it is nice to see that the update made to the OG colors that he came with his O-ring figure, and with the inclusion of some of the little paint apps that they've added to the missiles, whether it's the crash test dummy missile, which Lenny had shown, or it looks like almost a World War II paint job for the teeth on another missile. I think it just kind of adds a little bit more depth to this particular character. And of course, for the folks who didn't like the Tiger Force but wanted the OG Bazooka, we've got the particular figure we've been asking for. So again, it is a repaint of the Tiger Force, but I think this one is just a beautiful figure and definitely will be an easy pickup for me. Torpedo is just an absolute gem of a particular figure. Nice to see all the accessories that he comes with. You're able to store all the accessories on the figure, whether it's on his rebreather pack or you know, with the weapons and the flippers and all of that, but also just what we'll be able to do with some figure photography for this particular character. Lenny also mentioned that the fins for the feet are softer plastic, so they will bend, which lends itself well to not having that stiff-legged foot flippers that we used to get with the Real American Hero line. And then, of course, you'll be able to clip those on the backpack. So, again, this is kind of a cross between the Real American Hero line and then what was put out in the 25th and 30th anniversary. So, just a nice upgrade for a particular favorite of mine, Torpedo. Shipwreck, wow. I was a little bit unsure of what to expect for this particular figure with the swap out hair, which has been hit or miss with either Lady J or with Zorana. But I think for Shipwreck, this is a home run. I like how they updated Polly with the peg leg, which helps allow for the for Polly to be positioned onto to Shipwreck using the rope as a way of anchoring him. And then, of course, all of the accessories. Nice throwback to what Shipwreck came with the Real American Hero line, as well as staying true to that original design. And, of course, this gives us more opportunities for more Shipwrecks down the line. Thinking back to the 30th anniversary or the was a Dollar Tree wave where we did get an updated Shipwreck. But again, home run figure. Love the paint app and decos for the tattoos. I just think it's another home run. Rock and Roll. Oh, what a beefy boy this is. I love the devil horn hand sculpt, and he is going to be coming with extra hands, which is a nice change for the classified figures. All of the different accessories, the detail that they went into, you know, he has paint deco on his helmet. It's just a beautiful figure. I can't wait to see what they do with maybe a version 2, or if we do eventually get an all OG green of Rock and Roll. Love the machine gun they put together for the M60 for him. Love all the bandoliers and the different tattoos that they've added. Just again, it's another home run figure for this particular wave. Now we're talking about some of these deluxe figures. And if we're looking at overall winner for any of the pre-orders today, it has to be Scrap Iron. We've seen what this Joe team could do with Serpentor, which I thought was probably one of the best figures that I've ever seen come out of Hasbro or pretty much any other company. And then you see what they did with Scrap Iron. The injury to the side of his face, the scarring, the burns, ruining his eye, and then also having the helmet that he'll be able to put on is just absolutely amazing. And then the detail work that went into his little rocket launcher so that it is a maneuverable robotic death machine, as I like to call it, the Death Tesla. This will be just one of those more amazing type figures that we've seen. Now, one of the big changes that Emily did mention is, you know, we did see the price tier, which we've seen for some of the other figures. If you remember Fiona and Crocmaster, I believe we're $41.99 US. These particular, what they call pet and figure, packs are now at $45. I think for the amount of accessories you get with the Death Tesla and the deco and sculpting you get with this particular figure, I am comfortable paying $45 for this particular item. I know some folks don't like the increase in prices, which I completely understand. You have to do what's right for you. But I think it's nice to have multiple price points where you can put different figures in those price points for deluxe, standard release, and then, you know, like a smaller deluxe figure so that you can get the particular items that you need to make these figures complete. And with this Scrap Iron, I think we're completely there. Absolutely just a bases loaded, bottom of the ninth home run by the Joe team on this particular item. Emily also did say that there is also a new price point for figure two packs. So we did get to see that with the Cobra female troopers, which it is $54.99 US. That puts them in line with pretty much the cost of two figures. The big difference is you do get more accessories. And with this particular two pack, which these female figures are all new sculpt, you do also get all the additional accessories with them as well, too. So it's just giving us more options where you can pick up multiple figures in one package, plus get all of the accessories as well. And it's also nice to see more females on the Cobra side to fill out your troop builder. Again, another easy pickup for these particular items. The only thing that just kind of threw me a little bit is the tan for the officer, I believe. I think I would have just loved seeing the accessories all in black, but, you know, I will take it. Snowjob, which kind of fills into the just above the regular release tier. So if you think it's like Sarge or Kamakura, where you're just going to get a few more extra accessories, but it's not into the level of figure and pet. And with Snowjob, you get an absolute ton of extra stuff. So you get the unmasked head, you'll get a masked head, you'll get the hood, the ski poles, the skis, snowshoes, his rifle, his backpack. And of course, with this particular figure, you can put all of his accessories on his backpack. So again, it's just a easy home run again for this Joe team. This particular figure looks amazing. One thing though is the Cobra female troopers and Snowjob were Pulse only exclusives in the US. I'm going to assume in Europe too. So it'll be interesting to see what that means for some of the rest of the world, if they will see them through other retailers or not. It would be nice though. I know Snowjob's one of those particular figures that a number of folks like. So it would be cool to see that he gets distributed through more channels if possible. But again, just an awesome figure. Another easy buy for me. One other side note, if you didn't notice during the fan stream, though, with some of the art, figure photography art pictures you saw, you know, we've been talking about the number of different bats we'll see. So if some of you remember during the 50th line, I believe it was, Snake Eyes came with a Skyhawk, but his counterpart was an Arctic bat. So it looks like we are going to see an Arctic bat at some point down the line. We know we are going to get a Snow Serpent. So it's nice to see the world of play for the G.I. Joe classified team is expanding now into the Arctic. We now have the Sea with Torpedo, so hopefully that means a Cobra Eel will be around some point. When we also see, you know, of course I'm going to go back to Dreadnoks, but it's awesome to see that the Joe world is expanding, and we will get to see more opportunities for some of our favorite figures to hit. So I hope you guys all have a great day. This was a quick review of all these awesome figures. I will put some links on where you can find some of these figures in the description below. Let me know who you thought was the best reveal of the day for the renders. How excited are you for Mutt and Junkyard or Quick Kick or Big Boa? And of course, with the product reveals, which figures were you like, OMG, I've got to pick that up? Talk to you guys all soon. Again, thank you for all your support for the Island Misfit Toy Collectors. We are now over 450 subscribers. You folks are absolutely legends in my book. Thank you very much for your support, for all the kind words and comments. You guys all rock. Remember, have a great day, evening, or morning, wherever you're at on the island. And more importantly, Yo Joe.